Hi everyone, it's Jim from TechHive here, and today we've got a rather exciting product. It's the Amazon Echo Studio, and we're going to unbox it. So before I get to the actual unboxing, let's tell you a little bit about this speaker. It's Amazon's top-end flagship Echo, and it is designed pretty much to rival the Apple HomePod and Google Home Max, but it does a couple of special features which elevate it over and above those devices. So without further ado, let's open the box. We've got Amazon's frustration-free packaging, so you just have to rip the little thing off and the box comes open, and we like that. So inside we've got a lovely fabric bag, so we can lift it out. So if I just pop that down there on the table, let's have a look and see what else we got in the box. We've got some documentation, probably not going to tell us a whole lot. And we've got a simple power cable with a figure of eight end, if I point it at that camera. Now, of course, because we are filming this from the UK, we've got the UK plug here. But of course, if you buy it in the US, you'll have a US plug. So let's put that over to one side. Double check. There's nothing else in the box. Nope. That's the box done. So if we put that down here, let's have a look at this thing then. There it is, the Echo Studio. So it's quite a big device. It's a little bit bigger than a HomePod, a little bit smaller in terms of footprint than the Google Home Max. It costs $199.99, so it's not too expensive, and it undercuts quite a few other of its rivals. If we have a quick look at the top, you can see that you've got your mic mute button, you've got your volume controls, actual buttons, which is nice to see, and you've got your select button, which you can press to call up Alexa if you don't want to have to speak to her for some reason to call up her name. On the back, of course, you've got the power connector, you've got a 3.5mm aux in, which is also a mini optical connection as well, and you've got a micro USB port, which I think is going to be for firmware updates rather than anything else. So the next thing to do is going to be to plug this this bad boy in. I will set up the Echo Studio, but let's talk a little bit about the features first. Now let's turn down the volume so we can talk. So let's go through a couple of the features of this special speaker before we set it up. It's got this slot in the front because there's a 5¼-inch woofer facing downwards, and that slot, which goes right from the front to the back, that allows the bass to really sound out. You've also got 3 2-inch woofers, one in the left-hand side, one in the right-hand side, one in the top, and you've also got a tweeter at the front. So there's 5 speakers, and it allows the Echo Studio to do sort of 3D audio. So Amazon's calling it 3D audio, but for everyone else, it's Dolby Atmos. So this is the first smart speaker which supports Dolby Atmos. And that means that it's unlike the HomePod, unlike the Google Home Max, unlike any Sonos speaker, which none of which support Dolby Atmos, this one does. And it's cheaper than those rivals as well. It also supports Sony 360 reality audio. So at the moment, Amazon is working with those studios to bring more and more music tracks into that format. And also, of course, it will work with your TV. So the Echo Studio will pair with a Fire TV Cube, a second generation one, the Fire Stick 4K, or the second generation Fire Stick, and it will actually be able to wirelessly transmit Dolby Atmos to 1 or 2 Echo Studios. So you can actually have sort of stereo sound, or you can have mono spatial sound. The main idea is that you would use it for streaming music, because that's what the Echo is all about. Of course, Amazon wants you to stream music from its own Amazon Music service, and that's why, really, it's launched Amazon Music HD, which is its higher quality music service that supports high-res audio. So you've got two different types of audio. You've got the high-res stuff, which is either CD quality or a bit better, or you've got the 3D audio, which is the Dolby Atmos or the Sony 360 Reality audio. So if you go for Amazon Music HD and you subscribe to that, then you've got your whole 50 million tracks in HD. But there's a small but growing collection of 3D audio. So at the moment, you'll pay about $4 or $5 more a month to get Amazon Music HD over the standard Amazon Music subscription. And if you're a Prime member, then you get a couple of dollars off a month. And of course, if you want the family version of it, you'll pay another $5 a month, which brings it up to, I think, $19.99 a month. Now, one of the problems, of course, with doing a video like this is you can't hear what we can hear. So we can't demonstrate that 3D audio. We can't demonstrate how good the bass is or how good that HD music sounds. It's one of those things that you have to listen to for yourself. But trust me when I say that I've heard it and it really does sound very impressive. Now, one thing I would say is that the bass isn't incredible. It's not quite on the level of the Apple HomePod, but you can pair this with an Echo Sub if you want to get better bass, and that's a wireless connection to that separate Echo Sub. So let's set this up and get it working in the Alexa app. The setup process is pretty much exactly the same as any other Echo. So first of all, you launch the Alexa app. You tap on the menu, and then you tap the top option, which is add device. It's an Amazon Echo. So you scroll down the list until you find Echo Studio. Tap on that. Now we've got our orange light already spinning around. So the app's going to go and search for it. Just tap on it when it finds it. And then it's a simple case of tapping on your Wi-Fi network. If you've already set up an Echo before on your network and allowed Amazon to save the password, it won't even ask you for that password. It will just use that saved password and connect straight away to your device. So the device is connecting to your Wi-Fi. And as you can see, that's it. The process is done. We're set up and we simply need to tell the app in which room we've put the Echo Studio. So in this case, it's going to be in the living room or the lounge. So tap on lounge, tap on continue. If it fails, just try again. There we go. It's worked this time. And if we turn up the volume.
Experience immersive three-dimensional audio. Ask me to play the best of 3D music.
And one of the things I forgot to mention was the fact that, like the Apple HomePod, this has microphones in it that will automatically adjust the sound and optimize it for your rooms, depending on how far away your wall is, how high up it is, to get the best sound. Now, we're going to spend some time listening to it, testing it out more, so that we can bring you a full review shortly on TechHive. Hope you like this video. Please do like and subscribe, and we'll see you on the next one.